But because he has overcome the world, we will overcome the world. He still sets the standard. Amen. The enemy will lie and deceive. I was talking to a man not too long ago, and he said, you know, I battled alcohol. He said, it took me to the very end of my rope. I went on to living and having nothing. He said, I turned to Jesus. He said, for several years I lived for the Lord. He said, but then I felt I was done wrong by a Christian. Yikes. First of all, we have to be careful. We can't wear our feelings on our shoulders. Sometimes folks don't mean it. You know what the old devil got in there and lied to him? He said, from what I thought was bad, he said, became worse. He said, I turned away, I rebelled. He said, not only did I do alcohol, but I started dabbling in drugs. I found myself homeless, living on the streets. He said, I broke into an old abandoned restaurant, and there I slept and lived until one day I made my way to a mission and said, I can't do it any longer. I need Jesus. You know why the devil gets in? He lies and he deceives. He gets people to turn their eyes off of Jesus and forget their position that they have in him. And he takes them down a long road. We will battle the devil to the day that we die, my friend. Be sober and be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, when he's walking around like a lion seeking whom he may devour. But know this. Christ gives us freedom from him. He's a liar. He's an accuser. But Christ has given us a position in him where we live and we live more abundantly. Let's live there. Tonight, let's live free. I don't live by that old sin nature. But I'm free. I'm living in Christ. I'm going to allow us together in tonight, and let's take some time to pray. When you're done praying, you can be dismissed. I'm going to set the offering plate out, put your offering in there if you'd like. But let's spend some time just recognizing who we are baptized in Christ and the freedom he gives us. Let's gather in tonight.